In this tutorial, I'll show you how this animation was created in 11 minutes. This is an advanced version of the volumetric particles that I have introduced on the previous tutorial. It's also using a camera that's following path, and tracking an empty object at the world center. I'll select all the meshes, type M, to create a new collection, and hide them for now. Let's create a cube. S to scale. S and X to scale on the X axis. Let's create a UV sphere. Control 3 to subdivide. Right click and shade smooth to smooth the surface. Let's scale it much larger, so we can use the sphere as the background. I'll add a dark material. For the cube, I have used an emission shader. Please remember to change the render engine to Eevee and use Bloom. After selecting the sphere, let's add volumetric particles. Please match my settings. Please watch how the overall shape changes when I continue to make the changes on the settings. Time to create a text object. I'll extrude and bevel the text. Type G to move the text to the world center, and move the origin to the 3D cursor. I'll share the full node shortly. Here are the full nodes. This material was designed to reflect a shiny gradient color on its light reflection spots. I'll show you how the camera animation was arranged. This is the curve path the camera is following via constraint. I'll show you how this curve was created. Let's press Shift, A, to create a curve circle. If you don't see that in the menu, please activate an add-on called Extra Objects. We need 8 sides. Please click the 3D button. I have moved 2 points upward like this, and randomly rotated the curve. I have randomly rotated the curve on X, Y, and Z axes. Also, try typing R twice while rotating. After that, I have selected the camera and added a constraint. There are 2 constraints. One is following the curve path, and another is tracking an empty object at the world center. Before applying the constraints, please remember to select the camera, type N, to bring up the properties window, and reset its location and rotation as 0. The camera won't have distancing issues after we follow that procedure. I'll show you how the logo animation was arranged. It's difficult to tell, but the logo itself was rotating on its own, while the camera was zooming in and out while moving. The last frame was set to 100, and the same keyframe was added at the frame 0, 20, 80, and 100. From frame 0 to 20 and frame 80 to 100, the logo won't animate. It will stand still while the camera is moving and rotating. It's frame 50 that has a different rotation value. Please set any rotation values to make the logo turn drastically. This is how the logo animation looks like, without the camera movement. This is how the camera travels, and that's how the entire animation was created. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.